In this tutorial, I'll show you the basic steps needed to create Object2VR movies from your single or multi-row image sequences. When Object2VR opens, this welcome screen appears with some handy information like a direct link to the documentation and recent blog posts. You can close this to get started. The first step is to import your image sequence into Object2VR. So I'm going to start by selecting my images here and drag them right into the light table. And here, in the project dimensions, we see that I have an image sequence of 18 images or columns. It's a single row project and it has one view state. And that's all I really need to do, so I can output this as it is. I'll add a web output, and then I'll click the Generate Output button. If you haven't saved the project yet, you'll be prompted to do so before you can export it. And it's good to note that the project directory is used as the base for all the exported files. And here's my interactive Object2VR movie. I can spin it around and I can zoom in. And I can actually zoom in quite a bit before it gets blurry. And that's because of multi-resolution. This isn't a single image we're looking at, but multiple levels of resolution. So that as we zoom in, the images are being loaded. And you might have noticed that the object is spinning in the opposite direction of the mouse. So I need to fix this, and I'll go back to the project to do that. To change the direction of the spin, I just need to go to the viewing parameters and scroll down to the control section, and then select reverse for horizontal. And let's quickly output this and check it out. And okay, we're now spinning in the correct direction. Now let's go back to the project and add some more to it. I want to give my project a title. So to do that, I'll first click on the viewer to open the project properties. And here in the user data, I'll give my project its title and I'll add a description. I'll also add a skin. A skin is an overlay that gives us text, buttons, and images. I'll add one of the built-in skins. I'll use Featherbox, and then I'll save the project and then output it. Now Object2VR is asking us if it's okay to overwrite the previous output. I'll click yes. Okay, now we see the title and an info button that shows the description. It also has share and full screen buttons. But you might notice that this color here doesn't exactly match or work well on a white background. So let's change this. First, I'll zoom into the viewer. Because I want to use this blue color. And in the output panel, I can edit the skin's configuration by clicking this button. At the top here, I have an option to change the color. And I'll click on the color well to open the color picker. Now I want a custom color, so I'll choose Pick Screen Color, and then I'll hold down the mouse and drag. And once I'm at the color I want, I let the mouse button up. And then I'll click OK. Now let's see if that makes a difference. I think I could call this finished and leave it at that, but there's still a little bit more I want to do. Before we go on, I want to point out that this project hasn't been uploaded to the internet. By default, the project opens in your browser, and we can see in the URL field, localhost. This means we're viewing this web page locally on the computer. It has not been uploaded to the internet. Instead, Object2VR has an integrated web server, which lets us immediately view the project without having to upload it to a hosting service or web server first. This also means that this URL can't be shared as is. Now, if you want to share the project, there are a few different options. The project is outputted to a folder with all the files you need. So one option is to upload this folder using an FTP client to your web server and link to the index.html file. Another way to share your project is to export it as a Garden Gnome package. This takes all those files and zips them up into a single file called a ggpkg. Now, this you would add to your WordPress site using our WordPress plugin, which will recognize this file. And then you can embed the project into your post. This also works for Joomla and Drupal. Now, if you don't have a WordPress, Drupal, or Joomla site, and you're still wondering what I'm talking about, don't worry. We have yet another solution, and that is to upload the project to our cloud solution called Gnome Cloud. So click this button here to upload it to the cloud. And once that's uploaded, we can share this link, embed it, or even download a QR code to that project. So there are multiple ways to share your project. Now let's add some more interactivity and points of interest to the project using hotspots. A point hotspot is a point of interactivity. It's used to open websites, images, videos, text, and even PDFs. So I have this YouTube video here opened in my browser. It's about radial engines, and I want to add that as a point hotspot. So I'm going to drag the URL from my browser right into Object2VR, and it immediately adds it as a point hotspot and fills in the video's title and URL. Now I'll output this and see how it looks. Here's the point hotspot, and when I click it, the video opens as a pop-up that's been created by the skin. And to close it, I just click anywhere here. So that's a point hotspot, just a single point of interaction. Now let's create a polygon hotspot, which is an area of interaction. In the hotspot list, I'll create a new polygon hotspot. This adds a polygon hotspot to the list, and it changes the viewer to polygon hotspot mode. I'll zoom in a little, and then I'll start drawing the polygon by first double-clicking to add the first handle. And then I'll move the mouse along, creating the shape and adding handles with a single mouse click. You can add as many handles as you need, and then when you get to the end of the shape, double-click to close it. You'll see you have a handle here in the center, which you can grab and move the entire hotspot. If you need to adjust the shape, you can click and drag the handles. You can add a handle by clicking on the border, and to delete a handle, right-click it. This polygon hotspot is going to link to a Wikipedia article, so I'll keep the type as URL. And I'll add a title, which will act as a tooltip. And then I'll add the URL. I'll output this and see how it works. So here's the Polygon hotspot, and when I click on it, it opens the website. So there are a few things here that I've noticed that I want to fix. For instance, when I move the object around, these hotspots are only in the first image. The other thing I noticed is the white text of the tooltips doesn't work well here, so let's quickly fix these. The first thing I'll do is change the skin to Venice, because this skin has more contrast for the tooltips. Now I'm going to go back to the hotspot list and select the point hotspot. In its properties, I'll select this to reuse it in all columns. This means we'll have an instance of this point hotspot in every image. For the polygon hotspot, I'll right-click it and choose Copy to All Columns. This is because I want to edit the polygon hotspot instances without changing the original hotspot. So I'm going to go through and quickly change these instances to match the area that's visible. In the areas where the cylinder isn't visible, I'll just delete them by selecting it and hitting delete. Also notice that the columns with an instance are highlighted yellow. So I'll save the project and output it. And now the point hotspot always shows, and the polygon hotspot appears only when that cylinder is in view, and they both have better tooltips. So that's a single row project. Let's move on and create a multi-row project. If you have a multi-row project, then your images might be named accordingly, or they might just be named sequentially, like this project. So when I add these to Object2VR, it recognizes that there are 72 images, but it doesn't know that there is more than one row. But it does suggest possible arrangements. I know that there are 18 images per row, and it only has one view state. So here I can click the arrangement 18 columns by 4 rows. I can click Update, or if I choose the wrong arrangement, I can click the warning symbol and it'll reset. So with 18 by 4 selected, I'll click Update. And we'll see right away that the light table is adjusted for the multiple rows. And if you need to, you can make these thumbnails bigger or smaller. Now I can quickly go through the images to make sure they're in the right order. And I'm just using my cursor keys to move between them. And it looks good. Now I'll add that video point hotspot again. But this time I'll select both in all columns and in all rows. Next I'll add a web output, and then I'll choose the Netto skin this time because it has a different controller. Now we have some zoom buttons that deactivate themselves when you've gone to the max zoom or to the minimal zoom. So it lets you know if you can zoom in further or not. We also have a button to change the way we move the object. When I'm zoomed in, I can either drag it, or if I click this, I can go back to spinning it. And now instead of using the buttons here to zoom out, I can click this and it'll bring me back to my fully zoomed out position. And that's getting started with Object2VR. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out our documentation and webinars.